In this example, we are given that an infinite large non-conducting plane of surface charge density sigma has a circular aperture of certain radius which is carved out from it. And we are given that the electric field at a point which is at a distance A from the center of aperture is found to be sigma by 2 root 2 epsilon naught. And we are required to find the radius of aperture in the sheet. We are given that due to this charge which is there on the sheet, and a disc is carved out from it. And in this situation, the electric field at point P is given as sigma by 2 root 2 epsilon naught. Now, in this situation, if we wish to find out the radius of this aperture which is carved out, we can say if this R, then we can simply state in the solution, electric field at P due to complete sheet is this electric field E1 we can write directly as sigma by 2 epsilon which we already studied. And after carving out the circular aperture we can write electric field at P only due to circular disc of radius R is, this we can write as E2, which is the electric field at P only due to the circular disc. This can be written as sigma by 2 epsilon naught 1 minus A upon root of A square minus R square. This is A square plus R square. This is the result which we already discussed in previous articles. Now, after carving out this disc, you can say the electric field at point P will be E1 minus E2 because from this complete sheet we have removed the section which is given as sigma by 2 root 2 epsilon naught. We substitute the values of E1 and E2 over here. You can see that E1 minus E2 will result sigma A divided by 2 epsilon naught root of A square plus R square is equals to sigma by 2 root 2 epsilon naught. Here sigma and epsilon naught gets cancelled out. And on simplifying this result we'll be getting, if you just square the expression, this will give us 2a square is equals to a square plus r square, which implies the radius of this section which is carved out is equals to a. That will be the answer to this problem.